Hey guys, BigNate84 here. Thanks for joining me yet again in another episode of Live Sound 101. And in today's video, we will talk about what actually defines a live sound system. And we will talk about how live sound or sound reinforcement is a specific type of sound system. There are many different types of sound systems, so we'll talk a little bit about what makes live sound unique and sound reinforcement unique. And we will also take a look at a signal flow diagram. So we haven't really gotten into the good stuff yet, the meat and potatoes of live sound. You know, later on in this series, we will cover mixing technique and logistics and approaches to live sound to be successful and create a good mix and be able to direct people and get a good microphone test out of them. Sometimes the performers can be difficult to work with, and to try to get a good sound check can be challenging. So we'll talk about all that stuff later, and EQ and setting levels and all that good stuff. That's coming later, but right now in these first few videos, I want to lay down a good foundation of knowledge so that you guys can feel comfortable mixing and really understand the systems that you are running if you happen to be an operator of a live sound system. So anyway, to recap what we've gone over so far, in the first video, the introduction, we talked about using your ears, listening, understanding music, and I gave out some recommended reading. In the second and third video, we talked about some lingo and jargon and some terms that you should know. And by no means is this a comprehensive list. It's just to get you started, to give you something to chew on. We will be adding to this terms library as we go throughout this video. So we will be constantly learning new things, learning new terms as it becomes applicable in this video series. And in the fourth video, we learned about three common analog audio signal types. Now, why is it important to know the difference between these analog audio signal types? How do they fit into the picture of live sound? How do they fit into the big picture of live sound? And what is sound reinforcement? So that's what we have going on in this video right now. So many types of sound systems exist. You could have a sound system in your car, sound system in a movie theater, sound system in an airport, or in an auditorium. Now, each of these will have some similarities and some differences depending on what the needs are. So when we talk about sound systems, or specifically sound reinforcement systems, we're talking about live sound. So there is acoustic energy that you are capturing, converting that into electrical energy, manipulating it, and then converting it back into acoustic energy. So that is just the basic premise of sound reinforcement and live sound. So let's take a look at a little diagram I put together to better explain this and hopefully tie everything together. So we've covered the analog audio signal types, and you'll see them in this diagram right here. But basically, as I just pointed out, you've got low-level acoustic energy in a room, and you are capturing that energy with an input transducer, converting that to electrical energy. You are then manipulating the electrical energy through signal processing, through mixing, through amplification. And then you are finally converting back to acoustic energy, but to a higher level acoustic energy. And that is basically what makes a live sound system or a sound reinforcement system unique to some of these other systems that you might find in a car or in a classroom or in a home theater or a a paging system in an airport. Although that does have some element of live sound to it, it's just a slightly different setup. So why is it important to know the difference between these analog audio signal types? Well, as you can see, the signal starts out coming from the microphone as a low-level microphone signal, and the mixer is designed to accept that signal. The mixer then outputs line level signal that the amplifier is designed to accept. And finally, the amplifier outputs speaker level signal that a speaker is designed to accept. So that's kind of how these signal types fit into the big picture of live sound. That's why it's very important to know the difference, because you cannot just take a microphone and plug it into a power amplifier. And you cannot take a power amplifier and plug it into a mixer. You need to match the signal types according to how the gear is designed. All right, coming to the end of this video, I did want to address some questions brought up from a user on YouTube. And his name was Mothy. And as this video series continues, if I get some good questions, I will take some time to address them towards the end of each video. So he was asking about plus 4 dBU and minus 10 dBV. He had a mixer that had a switch on the back, and the switch meant that he could choose what type of signal the mixer would output. And he could choose between plus 4 dBU and minus 10 dBV. And he asked me, what's the difference between the two and what should I use? And he then pointed out that, you know, when he uses plus 4 dBU, it sounds much better. It sounds much cleaner. It's a much clearer signal. But then when he uses negative 10 dBV, it sounds noisy and it doesn't quite sound right. And so I asked, well, what speakers are you using? What's in your system? And he said, well, I'm going from this mixer to some powered speakers, some Mackie powered speakers. And I looked up the speakers, and the spec sheet said that they had a sensitivity rating for plus 4 dBU. So there's your answer right there. The speakers were powered speakers, meaning they had an amplifier built into them, also called active speakers. So they were ready to accept a line level signal, but a professional line level signal, a plus 4 dBU line level signal. That's the sensitivity rating. That's what they were designed to accept. And he even pointed out that it sounded great when he switched his mixer to output plus 4 dBU as a nominal operating level. Now, when he used minus 10 dBV, it didn't sound quite right. Now, that's a different reference voltage. So we have plus 4 dBU, minus 10 dBV. The difference between those two types of signal is the U and the V. So the U stands for unloaded in plus 4 dBU, and the V in minus 10 dBV stands for voltage. And minus 10 dBV has a 0 dB reference voltage of 1 volt. Plus 4 dBU has a 0 dB reference voltage of 0.775 volts. So what we're talking about here is the difference between consumer level line level. I'm sorry, there was too many levels there. Consumer line level and professional line level. And basically, you need to understand your equipment and understand whether it's professional, consumer, or a combination of the two, and know how to match signals accordingly to get the best possible quality audio signal. Okay guys, hopefully that all made sense to you. Thanks for watching, keep bringing your questions, and stay tuned for the next video.